Hi everyone, today we'll see about LFT, liver function test, and what is our concerns in it. This video is truly for the beginners, not for the experts I mean. A careful interpretation of LFT can help to find out the cause and severity of the underlying pathology, such as deranged alkaline phosphatase can represent the cholestatic pattern of biliary pathology, AST and ALT can represent the hepatocellular pattern of pathology. The severity of the liver dysfunction or the biliary obstruction can also reflected in bilirubin level. And the degree of liver synthetic function can also be determined by the albumin level. And beyond that, prothrombin time is also a good marker of liver synthetic function. We know that the liver function tests are a group of tests. Let's have a brief idea about the tests included in LFT. Of course, we will start with the main test factors like SGPT, serum glutamine pyruvate transaminase, also known as ALT, alanine aminotransferase, and SGOT, serum glutamine oxaloacetic transaminase, also called as AST, aspartate aminotransferase. These are the enzymes mainly produced in the liver. There are other types of cell also producing this enzyme. And the level of SGPT or SGOT is usually coming up when there is hepatic cell is inflamed or injured. SGOT or AST has low specificity than SGPT because of its wide range of distribution. For example, if there is any muscle injury other than the liver, can also elevate the SGOT level in the blood. AST and ALT are good for determining the recent injuries. It will not tell you about the residual function of the liver. AST and ALT are normal means there is no ongoing process of tissue damage. It does not mean the liver is perfectly alright. Next is alkaline phosphatase. It's an enzyme found in several tissues. Because of that, it has also low specificity. Usually it is elevated when there is cholestasis, means any obstruction in biliary duct. And also, we can see it is elevated in pregnancies and bone diseases. Next, bilirubin. Okay, this bilirubin is coming to our blood after the RBCs break down. Okay, and we are measuring this one in the LFT, like total bilirubin, indirect bilirubin or unconjugated bilirubin, direct bilirubin or conjugated bilirubin. Okay, what are they? This unconjugated bilirubin or indirect bilirubin is coming to our blood after RBCs breakdown. Okay, after that, this unconjugated bilirubin is coming to our liver, and the liver is converting this unconjugated bilirubin or indirect bilirubin to direct bilirubin or conjugated bilirubin. After this conversion, it is coming out through biliary duct, and the kidney will excrete this one. And this unconjugated bilirubin or indirect bilirubin, the kidney cannot excrete this one because it is not water soluble. So, a higher value of indirect or unconjugated bilirubin in the blood means the liver is failed to convert this indirect bilirubin to direct bilirubin. So, there is some problem with the liver. Okay. The same time, a higher value of direct bilirubin or conjugated bilirubin in the blood means there is some problem with the biliary duct. It may be obstructed. Next, albumin. It's a protein made in the liver. It helps to transport elements and maintaining osmotic pressure between capillaries and tissues. Okay. A low level of albumin or hypoalbuminemia may indicate a chronic liver disease or liver injury. It will not help you in acute cases because the half-life of albumin is 2 to 3 weeks. Okay, a higher level of albumin maybe because of dehydration or high protein intake. Next is GGT, gamma glutamyl transferase. It is usually elevated by cholestasis or any blocks in the diet and alcohol abuse. And total protein. We all know that the protein is the building blocks of the cells. Okay, an elevated level of total protein may indicate chronic inflammation or infection. And the low level of total protein may be by liver dysfunction, kidney disorders, or malabsorption. Next is globulins. Globulins are a group of proteins. The major part is made by our liver, and the other part is by our immune system. Okay. A decreased level in globulins may be because of liver damage or kidney injuries or by our autoimmune disorders. Next, what is that AG ratio? Albumin globulin ratio. As we know, both are proteins. This test will give you an idea about the amount of albumin in compared with the globulin level in the body. Okay. Mostly, the albumin level is higher percentage than the globulin level. In case of infection, the body will try to produce more protein which involved in immune system, which is globulin. So in such situation, we can see an elevated globulin level compared with the albumin. Then the prothrombin time, the PT. It is reliable for both acute and chronic liver dysfunction. Why it is a good marker of liver function? Because the liver is synthesizing many proteins which involved in coagulation. If that not made, the coagulation will be disturbed. The clotting will not be occurred properly. So tests like prothrombin time and INR will go up. Okay, that's it. I hope now you may have an idea about LFT and what are the tests coming under this. If you enjoy my class, you may click on the like button and the subscribe button if not yet subscribed. Thanks for watching me. Bye-bye.